must get the do.
Cut! Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the do.
It looks like we're in a screensaver.
Yeah, we need to go higher.
Higher.
Definitely higher.
We're like yodeling high.
Yodeling?
No. Don't do that.
We should go even higher.
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh. I'm good.
Me too.
Adventure has a new look.
Let's go lower.
Lower.
Discover more in the all-new Subaru Outback Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru. Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
So six.
to the bomb hole.
Podcast. It's going to be very hot. It's going to be very uncomfortable for everybody.
The bomb hole.
Welcome to day two of the Woodward Peace Park Championships here from Mount Bachelor. And I'm Todd Richards. I'm joined by, obviously, the Bomb Hole crew right here. Two legends in the new snowboard media landscape. We have Chris Grenier and E-Stone. Stoney Buds!
How we doing, buds?
So good, my dogs.
Thank you.
I love how the loose usage of the word legend these days. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, it's really loose.
Very loose. Throwing that one around. Huh?
Very loose.
Okay.
We've lubed up legend, so you guys can use it as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
Anyway, pretty much every civilian's a legend at this point.
Yeah, very kind.
Is it a legend or a legend? I can't. Okay, here we go.
Let's go.
So we've had an amazing second day of competition here. We had the highest hand plant on the wall ride feature, which was intimidating to say the least, and also people just going sky high on the hips. Yesterday, of course, was our race day, which was anything but boring as well. And we kind of, you know, we came into this thing thinking like race day, it's not really high on the list of things that are going to be exciting, but boy, oh boy, were we wrong.
Mm-hmm. Mons Roisland was bulldozing gates. For the entire day, it was a bad day to be a racing gate. I'll tell you that much. Hey, I think we actually have a recap of that from yesterday. Kyle, you want to throw that on the screen? Yeah, let's talk about
this
race.
Yeah, let's check this out.
What do we got here, Todd?
Well, look over there on the course on your left. That is Oscar the Crouch. Now, that is Brock Crouch's new nickname because his jacket looks like it came from a garbage can. And, you know, he's out there racing. Right there, we see Darcy Sharp trying to get the wheelie through. And that was just, you know, that's just the tip of the iceberg of what we had yesterday. We had some amazing
Brock
matchups.
Brock Crouch, I think, just got done cleaning up the BP oil spill in
dirtiest,
that jacket.
Got that thing out of a dumpster. On the mountain.
Yeah, so that thing is not sanitary. If you go near Brock, do not touch that jacket. Now we got Mark Mick just. He was a stud out there. Look at him turning, burning. He knows what he's doing. Oh, that's where he
right
paid
there.
The piper.
Oops,
that's where he paid the piper.
Tripped.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's where Big Air Jair kind of took the win. The underdog came through.
Really, the story was all about these, you know, these guys that were not really being in their comfortable elements and throwing them into a race course, you know, where basically anything can happen. It was really the humbler yesterday, for sure.
It was.
Definitely the humbler.
Now, take a note on the left. You have Elena Height, just the form, the control, the edge work. She was just dialed in out there on the course yesterday.
I think
Todd.
She would have beat some of the men, personally. She
absolutely
looked the best out there.
Easily. And then Haley Langland as well. I mean, it was, we had kind of a crazy matchup on the women's side of things. It was so close that they had to go back up, re-rack, and do it again.
Mm-hmm. Photo finish.
Photo finish. Probably not as close as we were claiming it was, but we just wanted to see him race again.
Look at the bulldog just bulldozing these gates. Roisland just plowing through these things.
Did you guys happen to see his forearm today?
Oh, my God.
Yes. Yeah,
look at that.
It is. It looks like torn up meat right now. The biggest bruise I've seen in a while.
Oh. Yeah, there's our two champions on the screen with the axes.
Yeah, they are going Blade home with the hatchets from this. Mm-hmm. Definitely hatcheted that course yesterday. And then, of course, you know, transitioning to today. Yesterday was racing. We have this overall point thing that's going on here. So they were in the lead for a little bit as it's a, you know, what do we say this is? This is a marathon, not a sprint. Yeah, sure.
So we got to play the long game.
Yeah, we play a long game here. Obviously, today was two of the most spectacular events that we would possibly see here, you know, and as far as, like, spectators go, it was amazing. There was a full-on peanut gallery.
Built right next to the chairlift. That was by design, I'm sure, so everyone can see. And then people just lining up on the side, screaming at the big airs.
Yeah, I noticed a lot of Stony Buds, how you doing so good, my dogs, from the lift today.
Yeah, there was maybe 10 of those today. Yeah. I had to move away from under the lift for a little bit.
I see you had your camera flare on you. I didn't actually see you pointed at anything except for the snow, but you definitely were wearing a camera today.
You know, some people get gold chains, diamonds. You know, I wear a $10,000 camera on the neck.
It's a good flex.
The new stuff.
That's
right
a
there.
Good flex.
Yeah, it is a good flex. But we have some footage today, a little recap of how the hip went.
A preview. We got a preview.
Oh, preview.
We're going to do preview first. We're going to show what we got so the viewers know what kind of setup we had. So if you look at this, we're calling it the WOD, Todd, the Wall of Doom. That thing is 24 feet off of, I think, like a 24-foot quarter, 48 feet tall.
You know, they used to call me WOD Richards.
I heard that actually.
Yeah, it's their signature Richards. Feature. That's the Wad Richards wad right there, is what
the
everybody's calling it.
Doom.
Now you have a front side and back side hip, and you got a giant skyscraper in the middle.
Yeah. I mean, today, obviously, our minds were absolutely blown with what happened. But looking at thing yesterday, you and I were kind of like, ain't no one making it to the top of that thing. No way in hell.
No.
Boy, were we wrong.
I'll tell you what. It was a little bit like a Pink Floyd The Wall concert. People were tripping watching the action today, if you know what I mean.
Well played. Well played, buds. I'll tell you, I know a lot of the riders were having night terrors all night. I heard like hospital visits due to like insomnia because they were so scared. And when you show up to this thing, I mean, you're basically straight lining into a wall or a hip, and it's a nightmare situation, really.
Yeah, it really is. And it's like, you know, as much as you can plan for something like this, and I know, like, you know, Danny Davis with the course guys that were out here kind of designing these things on a napkin, it's one thing when you're sitting at a restaurant and Danny's like, yeah, I think I might want to do something like this. And then next thing you know, it's built and you're all, oh, we have to do this.
Yeah, is this going to even work? What's going to happen?
But it did. I mean, I was looking at that thing kind of skeptically about, like, it's a little, you know, maybe it's a little oversized.
I'm under the theory if you build it, they will come.
Yeah.
And they will do this. And they did.
Yeah, they absolutely did.
Now, I think that a lot of the viewers, like, I think they want to see some of the action, you know? So I think, you know what, Kyle? I think it could be a good time to throw our, you know, the warm-up montage we have of these riders right when they started getting into it.
And they kind of got right to business out there.
So here we go. That's Red Gerard just flying up the wall. He just...
He came out hot.
I think he went 12 feet up the first time he hit it. Yeah. You know? So these riders were destroying.
Hey, look at that warm up.
Raibu.
That is a warm up.
Right out of the gate, Raibu. That was probably his first air on the hip.
And the weather was playing hide and seek. The sun was, at least. But, you know, one of the stars that's not actually in the competition, but just decided to show up and blow up was Sebbe. I mean, Sebbe was unbelievable. How not scared he is of going incredibly fast at very tall obstacles.
Mm-hmm. You know, we just saw Gabe Ferg, and he only hit the thing five times, but everything he did was incredible today. Shout out to Gabe Ferg. And then Sebbe DeBuck, he paid the piper today.
Mm-hmm. Would you say Sebbe got DeBucked?
He did get DeBucked. Yeah. Yeah, that was like a miss the hand, goes crippler, whiplash. Luckily, he's okay. He didn't get a concussion or anything. He said his jaw was a little sore other than that. There we have Zoe on the screen. Current Olympic gold medalist in slopestyle. And then Zebulon.
Yeah.
Planet Zebulon.
Look, I mean, are you joking? And he's not, he's right. How big is the board again?
205.
205.
205 centimeters.
There's Raibu. Just a people's champ out there on the hip today.
Yeah, and the fact that you could be on the lift and look over, and Raibu is going just as high as you are on the chairlift.
He really
was. It's a real experience for the customer out there.
And old Sebbe trying to tear down the Berlin Wall right there pretty much did by the end, and we will get there later in the show, but what a show it was today.
And Mark Mick was quick to get some amplitude on that hip. He's a true professional, as you can see.
Yeah, not just a jumper off the slopestyle.
And then you have Max Warb, who we're actually going to have on the show in a little bit. There you see him. He was definitely nailing it on the wall all day long. And
doing it for the locals, right?
Yeah, he's a Bend local. He put Bend on his back, actually. He actually said after the contest he might get Bend tattooed across of his back or across his shoulders. So there's a couple rumors circulating about that.
Throwing Bend on the back.
Well, let's talk about real quick, like, the hip. You know, the thing that's crazy about hips is the margin for error. Like, you know, you set a track, and if you go 2 feet, you know, 2 inches to the right off the top of the lip, and you're going backside, you're landing dead flat. You're falling 40 feet out of the sky.
Mm-hmm.
I think, to me, hips are the most dangerous thing you could possibly hit. And then, obviously, the 24-foot wall is psychotic.
Yeah, there's a very subtle difference between landing perfectly and base jumping into the parking lot.
And what's funny is these guys just handled it like the pros they were, and we didn't even see that today.
Yeah.
Also, got to give a huge, huge shout out to the park crew. Those guys have been working for freaking weeks on that mound of snow, and it was a sculpture. That
it was fun watching them enjoy the fruits of their labor and see it work out, and the smiles on their faces. And I hung out with them a bit at the beginning of the session. They're just high fiving, and really hyped.
Were you throw out some high fives, bud?
Yeah, I did. I high-fived the bros. I'm rooming next to them down at the Lowe's, and nice. I'll tell you what, these are a good crew of guys right there.
The park crew, I'll always say it, they're the unsung heroes of the snowboard community. You show up, there's a beautiful park in the morning that everybody worked hard for. So check out Peace Park anywhere you're at because it's beautiful. But let's talk about some standouts in that first session, Todd. What did you see?
Well, obviously, you know, we're going to talk about Zeb a lot just because I feel like when you're riding something like this, especially, I mean, with the wall ride, you could tell that Zeb just wanted to put his hand on top of that thing. And he obviously didn't care about life or limb going into it. But Red, I think Red was just handling. You could tell he was, like, focused, really wanted it. And, you know, Max Warbington was just, he, like you said, he threw him bend up on his back. But he's a hand planter. Mm-hmm. You can tell that guy knows his way around an invert. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he was trying to put it up there as high as he possibly could, too. It was kind of cool to watch people work out what would work better, like a frontside invert or, you know, your basic, like, just backside andirect or whatever you're going to do. And it was fun to see who had the different techniques going in at that and what would actually get you up there a little higher.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, and again, you know, let's talk about bend locals because you had Fat Gabe. I think he only hit the thing five times, but every time he went to the moon and he did a, you know, hand plant really high and he was, you know, he likes to not put a lot of effort in. That's his shtick, I think. And then you had, you know, Raibu right out of the gate went huge. Mark Mick right out of the gate went huge. I mean, it was unbelievable.
You know who impressed me out there?
Who's that?
This kid, Mason Jar.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, fun fact about him. You know about his bloodline?
I do.
Let's hear it.
Jake Blauvelt.
That's built champion blood just running through his veins, and wow. I think he proved it today.
He also made the biggest bomb hole in the quarter pipe later on in the competition.
Yep, he basically made the wall ride unrideable due to him putting a six-person dual jet hot tub into the in-run of that from his front flip.
You know, I'm kind of, maybe next time they do this thing, and you know, you get this wall ride, you get this hip, we could do highest hip replacement air for us. You know, I think that might be good to get out there and, you know, have the older guys take a crack at this thing and, you know,
at that hip.
Yeah,
let's
maybe
go
get some hips.
We you know, might if, be able to arrange this
if
for you, you
if you've got a hip replacement lined up, maybe just finish your hip off right there on
call.
The hip, and then you just go get a new one on Monday.
Absolutely. I think that's a great idea, Todd. Yeah, we didn't see, we had a couple poachers in there today too.
Yeah,
a
we had Ben some locals. Some Ben homies were in there kind of
going big
it.
Too
takes hips, like you said, it's one of the scariest things to ride. I think, you know, as we move on this weekend, and the next event that we have is the actual Peace Park, the half park. That's going to be more of an exhale because this thing today, I think, was basically you just kind of had to, like, sack up and ride as fast as you possibly could.
Yeah, and only a small amount of riders are really going to shine in that kind of situation. I think tomorrow everyone's going to shine in their own way.
It's going to be very interesting to see how that goes.
Yeah, a lot of prestigious riders. Now, one thing I think we should talk about is, you know, the history of this wall, you know, because they've done the wall for a number of years. And I think the last time they did the contest, there is some archival footage of the wall. I don't know, Kyle, can we pull that up so people can see? Yeah, this is 2019.
Yeah,
COVID.
This is right before the world ended. And you see right there that it's 24 feet high, highest hand plant on that wall. No one really
16 feet, correct?
Yeah, no one really got too close. I think Nick Baden had an 18-footer. Yeah, but it was a struggle. And that was the reasoning was is because you get G'd out. G-forces coming into that quarter pipe were really strong. So it was, you know, Danny's goal was to alleviate some of those G-forces coming into this thing. And I think they really did that because, I mean, as you saw, people got really high up on that wall today.
Well, and the difference was, I think, being hand-built versus machine-built.
Mm-hmm.
And today's wall, the quarter pipe was hand-built, allowing you to have that. As they build, the builders are able to shape it as they go and kind of get that perfect tranny, where the machine is just more like a half pipe and harder to get up as high. And we proved it today when
kind
what
of
we saw.
If you build it, they'll come scenario.
Yes,
buds.
That is exactly it. Kevin Costner, I believe.
Yes.
Said that?
Field of dreams.
Field of dreams.
This is the field of nightmares.
Yeah, it's a field of nightmares. There were definitely nightmares last. Did you guys happen to see Dusty this morning? Pacing around, just like staring at the wall.
I will
stare at the wall.
When these guys, I mean, obviously Chris and I were on a megaphone up there really shouting words of encouragement or, you know, just trying to fracture people's souls as they came into this thing. And we yelled at Dusty because his billowing was slowing him down.
Yes. A lot of wind drag.
It's like a sailboat, but...
And, yeah, But I think that means we should go to a commercial right now.
Yeah, looks like they tried to cut to a commercial, so let's might as well hit that right now.
So many flavors of dew. I am thirsty. I must get the dew.
Cut! Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the dew.
Oh, it looks like we're in a screensaver.
We need to go higher.
Higher.
Definitely higher.
We're like yodeling high.
Yodeling?
No. Don't do that.
We should go even higher.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Oh. I'm good.
Me too.
Adventure has a new look.
Let's go lower.
Lower.
That sounds good.
Discover more in the all-new Subaru Outback Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru. Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
The 2022 Woodward Peace Park Championships are being brought to you by Fat Tire, America's first certified carbon neutral beer. By Mountain Dew, proud partner of Peace Park. And by the all-new Subaru Outback Wilderness.
Hey, we are back here with the the after show, the banter marathon that we're going to have here every day after the events of Peace Park Championships. And we have a guest in the booth. This is Axe Warbington. And we will allude to why they're calling him Axe Warbington in a second, but Max Warbington's here. He's a Bend local, and he was one of the standouts today out there on the wall ride quarter. But what are we calling that thing? Oh, the Wad. Wad.
Yeah, Wall of Doom. Yeah. Big time.
Welcome.
Thank you. Great to be here with you guys. Good to have you in Oregon, up at Batchy's, chilling in the Nordic Center here, Bombhole headquarters for the weekend.
It's the mobile headquarters.
Yeah, it's nice. Great to be here. Today was sick as fuck.
Yeah. So
this is a PG-13 show.
It is. It's for the kids.
Sick as
yeah.
So that's what I said.
Well, today, obviously, when you've been watching the build for that thing for a few days, so what did you think when you rolled in here and you saw a 24-foot tall wall ride on top of that monster quarter pipe?
Well, being from here, you would think it's an obvious thing that I was here watching it, but actually, I was in Mount Baker, drove here on 419, mm-hmm. showed up for 420 and saw it just the same as all these other guys coming here. So I didn't see the build, and I had been hearing about it, hearing rumors and how big everything was. But when you see it in person, it's like a whole nother beast. Mm-hmm. The wall is just so scary. Like looking at it, the pads helped a little, but.
Oh, did they?
I mean,
I thought maybe you had this axe here to chop it down a couple feet. So
we were, yeah.
Now I'm wondering, like the thing is going into those things, how do you not speed check? Because I know going into big hips, it's like, go straight. You're going to a big wall, go straight. Don't speed check. And then you end up doing 5 speed checks. But right. you did a great job not doing that today.
That's like the biggest thing I tell myself in my head when I'm dropping in. Like, and slowly sort of work your way up, like pick that point where you can like just go straight and actually do it and like bend your knees on the way up. And that wall ride was crazy. Like I'd never hit anything like that before. And you really would like... You hit it real fast. You need to make sure you're going straight because you can't drift. It's so narrow. And you have to go straight up and down. So your feet basically just hit it and shoot out. And then there's like this weightless moment. And then you get your hand on it. And then you fall for a while on the way back down. And every single one of those, I was like full like Tony Hawk squat all the way through the training on the way down because it was like, I don't know.
Body mechanics. You're going body mechanics.
Full body mechanics, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm in the mind on the way in.
What's it?
Bend my knees, strong core.
What's it like floating up that thing and just kind of like waiting? Because it kind of was like you had to really wait and take your time and be patient. The people that snapped, you mm-hmm. watched them kind of go in.
Totally. Yeah, it happened to a couple of people. Like, and I think that's sort of why like I thought it was less scary. As soon as I hit it one time, I thought it'd be less scary to go backside mm-hmm. invert instead of frontside, because the frontside you have like a snap movement and the backside you can kind of like slowly slip. But it was like I never had it such slow-mo where you go and I was like hit the wall, looking at my tail, like waiting to stop going up, and then like putting my hand down. Mm-hmm. And that one, I just floated a back three, no touch. And like, it was like, didn't feel very much different than the other ones.
Yeah, you were like, you know? A mime, just.
Yeah, kind of like, should I touch it? I don't know.
Now, should we break down the reason why he has that axe?
Yeah, let's talk about it. Go ahead.
Yeah, let's bring out the axe.
Yeah, why did you get that thing today?
Yeah, I feel a little like there's a caveat with this because Zeb he's not on the leaderboard. Mm-hmm. Like, he touched the coping.
Yeah.
Let's just put that out there, you know? And I came in somewhere in the 20 something. And yeah, highest one of the day out of the people besides Zeb.
Yeah,
highest hand plant winner. Give it
so
up.
So, like the normal human beings, right. I got the best. And then there was also Zeb was there. So,
well, the reason is so people
here's
know.
A shot of it oh, yeah, right here. Look at that.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Dink.
Gets that.
Oh, I mean, little sketchy on the grab.
Yeah, you had clean ones.
There
as
was
well.
Some clean ones in the mix.
I had some photos of you where you were definitely grabbing.
Wait a second. You shot a photo today?
Well, no. With my phone.
Oh, you have some from previous years.
I had some looking at Yoshi's camera, actually. Or Blotto's, maybe.
I mean.
17.
It's so gnarly to
watch
that.
There's that squat.
Every
time. It's a crucial crouch right there. The Brock crouch.
There's that fisheye shot we've been looking for. Mm-hmm. That was an early one.
You were like just throwing all sorts of different grabs, not trying to figure out what was the best.
Yeah, it's kind of
most comfortable.
Yeah, it depends on how your feet slip out. I was either going melon or nose, like split second decision, pretty much.
And so, also real quick, so people know, like Zeb, the reason why he's not on the like in it is because he's only doing day one, day two. He couldn't stay for day three, so he was.
Did you hear where he's headed?
Yeah, he's flying to Miami.
Yep.
Yeah.
He's gonna be driving cars in Miami Beach, just having a good time, and you can't blame him, I guess, mm-hmm.
No,
stepping away.
Living his best life.
When he comes in and just hits the top, you know, he hit literally. You know,
I mean, he
was
threw that the rock and roll.
Can we talk about the 6-inch high backside air on a 50-foot quarter pipe?
Yes.
Yeah. He did the highest air out of a 50-foot quarter pipe today. It was 6 inches out.
Totally. Yeah.
Yes, it was.
It's messed up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was unreal.
Yeah.
Unreal. I think Zeb was just kind of throwing stuff at a wall to see what sticks and a lot of different stuff. I even saw him do some Spider-Man maneuvers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He was like snaking people on the way in, like hungry for that.
Yeah.
It was sick to watch.
Let's talk
Proud
about,
coach here.
Let's talk about a couple other clips, though, because I don't think we have them, but you did a full back three. And then you did
floater
and direct.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
A bunch of those. And then. The one of my favorites, Todd basically blew a gasket.
Lost my mind.
On the hip. I don't know. It'll probably be later in a montage, but method front 180.
Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah.
The rewind.
That's been a fun one. I've been working on that, training it up. I did one really big on a park jump in New Zealand at that Jossie contest, mm-hmm. and then kind of figured it out there where when you have the second to like hold your extension on something big, when you let go of your grab and you snap everything together, you like can spin kind of easily.
It's incredibly difficult. I mean, we used to try that a long time ago, and I would do it in the pipe where I'd try to set up for something on the front side wall. It's so hard to make it look like you made that look today. I mean, incredible.
I'm always hyped on that one. It's like true. That's like a true jump pretzel.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you're this way and then you go full pretzel.
Yeah. So jump cool. pretzel.
Have you ever caught your toe edge on that one? Because that could be a disaster.
You got to be
like
aware
a fly
of that.
Swatter.
Yeah, talk about going down swatter. Hard.
You can't like... try to jam your toes in. Mm-hmm. You got to like either be ready to suck up and go to your ass or like stop.
Yeah.
And then also you let the hoof breathe out there.
Yes.
You were letting that hoof dangle.
Sketchily.
Yeah.
Let the hoof breathe.
High speed hoof dangle.
Yeah. I was
one
like
one footer for the people that are unfamiliar.
Dude, the
with
one footer of just for the sake of I'm not going to do anything with my back foot. I'm just going to do an air with my foot next to my binding. It was all that one too. There wasn't you didn't dangle the participle. You just kind of like
kept participle.
Participle.
Love that. Love
we don't
that.
Like that. As a one footer snob, we don't like
no.
that.
Oh, that's
you
a no
need
fly
to
zone.
Be tweaking it.
Yeah, you're supposed to get that thing out.
Exactly. And the one foot methods, they feel good when mm-hmm. you get them good.
You have a nice one of those.
And we were up on the yesterday we were on the cone with Dirksen for like the late lap snow skate backflip sesh and everything, but Dirksen's with us and he's like the 1 foot hip mm-hmm. method guy and one of my heroes, shred heroes, so like I had to hit that.
Mm-hmm.
I still want to hopefully we get another sesh on that at some point because I think a lot of people are still hungry for more on that whole situation up there.
Yeah, the light was
I'd like to launch
Cat and
a big
mouse
one
too. You know, for you guys, you couldn't really see anything towards you. Grandy's and I were like, why are they still doing this? The definition was not even, it wasn't like there was any blue dye to like give you guys an idea of where to go either.
I think Zeb, Red, and I, and probably some of the other dudes would have been higher up and like way nice on that wall if mm-hmm. it was good light all day long.
Was that wind messing with you guys at all?
I think on the hip. I wasn't just really like blasting the hip the way those guys were, but I think, I mean, there's no way it wasn't messing with
them. Yeah, it had to be.
It was flapping up there.
Well, I think it's a good time, batchy. Kyle. Maybe we should pull up montage number two. We got some more riding clips to go through. So there we go. I don't know. Who was that? Danny. That was Danny.
Danny. Just some beautiful plants all day.
Mm-hmm. You can see how flat light it is. Definitely adding to the difficulty of that plant.
That time you get up there like to reach for your grab and everything, it's crazy.
Kind of a lot of time to think about what could possibly happen to you if things aren't right coming back in.
No side drifters today, though.
Oh, this, thank how's God. This?
Yeah, look at this.
This is an incredible... This Takeru?
Oh, this is looking speed. Like a germ follow.
Boom.
Oh, my gosh. That is ridiculous.
It was a rare moment of a sun, too. That was nice.
Yep.
Looks like the crowd went absolutely berserk.
The squad at the top was pretty heat all day.
Oh, here's you right here.
Here we go.
Bingo.
Sick extension nice on that one. Yep. Perfect. Yeah, the power squat through the bottom using the shock absorbers.
There we go.
Ooh, that's up in the 20s.
I think that was the one.
That was up in the 20s.
So, yep.
Yeah, that was the one.
Here's going to be another big Raibu. Right, I got it. No problem. Let me just grab that real quick.
Everyone at the top thought he was dead on that one.
Yeah, talk about showmanship on that. Just kind of pulling it together.
And then gets it.
Zoink. Bink.
Air swim to lockout. Wow.
And that stomp.
That was what we call Air Bud Golden Retriever. Todd.
Yeah, it was an Air Bud Golden Retriever. And then you just landing with a high back straight in your bottom. Look at this right
there's
here.
There's one of those Spider-Man.
That was Spider-Man airs. That reminds me of like a Rob Machado toe side surfer on the news.
Yeah, a little
Todd.
Surfer on the
news. Yeah, we were calling that one the ham plant because you just press your ham right on the wall, plant. Right? Yeah, the ham plant right there. And then you get it back underneath you, and that's how you do it.
Did you guys already discuss Zeb's board choice for the day?
Like, yes.
Yeah. And pretty unreal.
It was amazing how he's just like a cat. Well, look at this. Wow.
Oh, there's a photo there. Somebody got that. Yeah. Bud, did you get that photo?
Definitely got that photo.
That was freaking huge.
Can we talk about, okay, so as the day went on, obviously the quarter pipe started to erode from where the wall ride began.
Yeah.
And at some point, Zeb all of a sudden would have that board facing the wrong way, and that big shrimp fork would be coming back down. The shrimp fork would almost catch where the meeting of the quarter pipe and the wall ride started. I was just waiting for him to just go and stick in like
skewer
tongs. Yeah,
it's like a Brazilian barbecue.
It really was.
Every time he came by, I was looking for some meat to grab.
He's going
off
hibachi
that
grill
fork.
On. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
It's like helping him get up the wall ride, maybe, but also like way dangerous in another way.
And he hardly. I don't. Did he fall?
Does the meat splat?
Define fall.
Yeah. He always seemed to end up on his board.
It's still a trick.
Yeah.
But that's another thing. You made this thing. You made it out unscathed. How the hell did you manage to do that?
I don't know. I was getting lucky and focusing on like trying to land it.
It showed
the
montage
feels like luck.
At the top. What was like the vibe at the top? Because you saw everybody hanging. Are they like, oh, geez, like, or are people hyped?
Most everybody was just super hyped. Yeah. It was like everyone's just like so stoked, pushing each other to go bigger. So dope to watch both those Japanese guys go like kind of head to head in a way, like who's going to go bigger. Amazing. Like, and watching people go big on hips in real life is like another thing.
Yes.
It's mm-hmm. crazy. Like mm-hmm. that thing had like sketch Wu-Tang a little, you know, and they're just handling it like popping super hard.
Another unsung hero of today. We must address this. It's Craig McMorris.
Oh,
dude,
yeah.
I was going to bring that up.
I went a little hard on Craig McMorris on the wall ride because he was doing kind of a dumpy hand plant.
I was doing that at the top.
But boy, oh boy, did he really come back
and
really shove it down our throats.
Mm-hmm. I think it's because you were gassing him up a little bit and giving him some a hard time.
Maybe. Look, there's a couple ways to do hand plants.
Right.
That wasn't one of them.
That wasn't one of them.
He said legit hand plants.
Well, any gripe you had with Craig is over the minute you see that frontside chuck come out.
Yeah.
Dude. So,
some call it a heinous chuck. I believe invented by Nate Farrell. He used to do those in the half pipe. And
when he does
backside
it, maybe.
Is a Michael chuck, mm-hmm. and then the frontside's a heinous chuck.
Mm-hmm. Really?
That's an East Coast term, so I don't know if that's
nice. Is it only heinous when Farrell is busted?
No, when you invent a trick, you get to name it. So, you know?
It kind of looks like a throwing star, like if, you know, you throw a cat out of a window or something like that. It's got that frisbee.
But mm-hmm. you guys were watching all day. Did he hit that FT?
Yes, FT. Yeah. He did one single chuck, and then the second one, he flipped, and he was like flipped it real slow, and then just squeaked it right in. He like, was calm as a cucumber. So
yeah, good. I saw him stomp it. It was insane.
And then did a couple backside airs on the other side of the hip, where it was kind of crusty. That landing was not as soft.
And he one-footed the wall ride.
Yeah, he one-footed the wall ride.
Yeah.
Great showmanship. Yeah, he's kind of underdog of the day. Mm-hmm. You know, known for broadcasting, but still gets in there and puts a beat down on the park.
Great. I was hyped when I saw his name up on the list to begin with. I'm like, hell yeah, Craig, let's fucking get it. Yeah. You know?
Now we got some Bend royalty in here. So I want to know who we got. Mace, Big Air Jer.
Yep.
Fat Gabe.
Yep.
Yourself.
Yep.
Who are we forgetting anybody?
Well, like kind of, there were some squeakers in there today who were also kind of Bend royalty.
Who are those guys?
Drew Brownrigg and Nate, you call him Duder.
Duder.
He was going huge at the end of the day there. Massive airs. He did some big hand plants too. So did Drew. Killing it. Both those guys are complete savages.
Now, who do you think underrated. Who would you say the king of Bachelor is out of that whole crew?
Well, the mayor. Oh, out of that whole crew?
I don't know, mayor.
Yeah, just
king,
to get mayor. Like,
the prince. The mayor is Chris Luzier.
Okay.
I'd say like the godfather, Jerry Lopez.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Dirksen's in the mix somewhere, obviously. Austin Smith.
Yes.
Also in the mix somewhere. Fergs.
Where do you come in there?
Yeah, where are you at?
Me and Ben Ferg are probably about on the same level. Mm-hmm. Maybe he's a little higher.
You're born raised in Bend, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
what about Curtis Cizik?
The Fergs are born in Idaho.
Oh.
At least Ben.
Oh, there's an asterisk.
Yeah, there's a couple asterisks in there. I was getting the heads up from Austin about there's a couple asterisks in the mix there.
Mason's an asterisk, not OG.
Mm-hmm.
Mason, yeah, so, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, there's a lot of them. And then those guys, Jared and Mason, they've been holding it down. Gabe, Ferg, everybody. We got Dylan Collins. There's a whole bunch of people around here right now that are just coming up and absolutely killing it. It's kind of been a steady flow of that happening, though.
Well, and I've always said that over the years. I mean, I'm a massive fan of Dirksen, and going way back.
Right.
Like, we're talking like Robbie Morrow.
He's triple OG.
Cut his teeth here. And the reason that those guys are so strong, and you're such a strong rider yourself, is that yesterday afternoon, after the snow kind of turned to garbage, there is a big difference between the riding ability of someone who comes from smooth-ass Colorado or Utah and then chunder death.
Right.
Up
flat
here.
Light.
Flat
chunder.
Light chunder going through Powell. It's a different comfortability. It's a Northwest comfortability with snow. And it separates the men from the boys out here.
Yep.
Yeah. How do you think Bachelor shaped the snowboarding for locals like yourself?
I think like people come out of this place, they're like good to go if you're going to be like a powder guy or any sort of like guy who needs to like get the speed right on stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what it is. Like, we're doing gaps. It's like these wind lips form up here. You need to mob a run and lose, like, no speed and then clear a gap and nail the speed.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, if you do that every day in, like, flat light and when it's good and when it's not good and, like, it just is, like, constant training. Like, watching, I was mad proud of, like, Jared in natural selection because he was just, like, you could see like the way he rode that was just like how he read Bachelor, where like he's super careful about where he's taking speed checks, like only where it's fresh and like popping, just like spinning late and doing all this stuff. Like we just grow up hucking here all the time and chucking stuff. And eventually like over the years it stacks up and you become insanely good. Like,
mm-hmm.
And there's also some prestige with the turning here too. You know, mm-hmm. you have Dirksen who's the kind of the king of turning, really.
Straight
up. And so it's kind of in the bloodline here for people to, like, you know, you guys do a bunch of bank slaloms up here in the Northwest, and it seems like that's great for the fundamentals.
And it comes from, like, those wind lips on the backside and stuff that we kind of got to see today. Like, it was fun to show everybody, even though the snow was, like, not as good as we were hoping, you still got to, like, be like, yo, this is it. Like, we ride this, like, you go over the back, and it's just these sick waves. Where, like, if you can hit one of those that's fresh and you paint a sweet line down the whole thing with, like, a little air and a nice slash, it's, like, a banger, you know, and something that happens, like, once every couple of seasons, maybe, even for us. So, and we got to, like, actually do that with everybody here, so that was great.
Yeah, let's talk about that. So, you guys got early ups this morning, real early ups.
Yeah.
The summit opened up. It hasn't opened up in a few days. Fresh pow up there. There was a big group shot that kind of had to be nailed. You guys had one shot at this super group shot from the top into a train in the Peace Park. Here it is, right here.
Looks
here.
Like we got it.
This Sweet. Is insane.
I haven't even seen this.
Yeah, it's really cool. I saw
Look
some
at
footage
that
of this.
Posse, huh?
Dude, just yep. wait. Wait until you see how oh, the train yeah. goes.
Yeah, so that's like right off the top. They call it the summit. You can ride in any direction you want. We're going straight towards the Peace Park here.
JP Minibike said he's lived here his whole life, never got early ups, so what a treat it was for you guys.
He snuck in there today.
Yeah, he snuck in.
Yeah.
Of course he
King
did.
Of sneaking in.
Yeah, I watched him and Jared and Austin sneak a run while this was happening.
You know, I talked to Curtis Cizik today, and he said he got up at 6:30 to get some fresh tracks, and when he went there, he said everything was tracked out to these guys. He was really happy about that.
Yeah, Curtis, when this group rode past the chairlift line and Curtis was standing there, that was nice.
Yeah. So you guys came, you did that face there, and then everyone went into a train into the Peace Park, and I thought that was really yeah. cool. Was that the first time you had actually taking a look at the half park setup?
No, I got in there yesterday with Cannon and like Zoe, which was epic. We got like two or three laps through, got to scope it. So then when we came through today, I had already hit stuff, which was nice.
Well, let's give a little preview for tomorrow. Yeah. So what is it like? Tell us in your words what we've got in store for tomorrow's big comp.
Yeah, so it's right at the top of the Cloud Chaser lift at Bachelor. It's the whole like half park, full Peace Park setup they have. Two like really dope super poppy jumps in a row that you can kind of like take. They're sort of like off kilter, so you can take them bigger, kind of hip style a little, but they're tabletop-y. And then it flows into like the half pipe section where there's just two like probably 22 foot or maybe they feel bigger walls where you can hit like one real big hit and then another one flow out. And then there's like the diamond thing, which is also another like off kilter jump with mad options for how big you go. And then my personal favorite, the crazy trapezoid rail up, flat, down.
That's an OG rail right
yeah there. It reminds me of some OG like old school video stuff for sure.
And then one thing sorry to interrupt, but I was gonna say the formula. I don't know, for some of the people tuned in, they might not understand how this contest works. So day one was a slalom and you get allotted points for your position. Day two, wall hip situation. Day three is the park, and whoever, and that's worth 40%. The rest are all worth 20. And so the you know, there's an overall winner and that's it. So totally. you got a strategy to go for broke. How are you feeling about this thing?
And it's kind of like, well, it's comboed between like rider judging and the judge judging.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to factor that in.
Rider judging, you kind of want to butter up your friends, tell them they're all looking really good.
Exactly.
Did you get a haircut today?
And hook them up with like, I'm going to be like kind of like hooking people up with beers tonight, like making sure people are warm.
You can't really play the psychological
sure they're warm.
Yeah.
The psychological warfare card doesn't really play tomorrow.
No.
It's like you got to buddy up.
Overly friendly.
Right.
But you know what? You could do psychological warfare because you could be like really mean to everybody and then you could be like, well, I'll vote for him because maybe this person's going to like me. You know?
That's a good way to put
reverse
it.
Reverse psychology. I like that. Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
Well, I think it's a good time to take a quick break and talk about some of our sponsors.
Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
Oh, it looks like we're in a screensaver.
We need to go higher.
Higher.
Definitely higher.
We're like yodeling high.
Yodeling?
No, don't do that.
We should go even higher.
Yeah,
let's do it.
Cool. I'm good.
Me too.
Adventure has a new look.
Let's go lower.
Lower.
That sounds good.
Discover more in the all-new Subaru Outback Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru.
Yeah.
I mean, dude.
Back.
Hi. Hello. Hi. I was just paying attention to my script. Do you know where we are in this thing?
Yes. We're with Haley Langwood.
Oh, hey, Haley. Wow. How are you? Hi.
Yes.
Yo. What up?
So you are overall, you're number two in points right now in the points chase. How are you feeling?
I think it's a pretty good spot to sit in. However, Jamie's kind of crawling up there, and she could definitely take this thing tomorrow. I'm pretty psyched to be right behind Elena, who is just an overall crusher. And it's been a fun couple of days.
Yeah, let's talk about yesterday real quick. In the race, you know, we had that photo finish. Yeah.
How did you feel about the photo finish? Did you think you had it, or was it really a photo finish?
No, I think it was a real photo finish. Like, I got to see one of the angles, and it looked like we were pretty much nose and nose going over the finish line.
I mean, it was your technique, right?
Yeah, I fully went full Baumgartner and shoved my nose out there. I even, like, got my body all across the snow. But, I could tell she was speeding up, so I had to do something, and it worked out. Too bad I was, like, so tired going into that tiebreaker lap, and I just lost my legs around one of the corners, and she was way far in front of me no matter what, though. I kind of knew she was going to pull away. She's quick.
I heard you say something, can we both win?
Yeah, I heard that. I heard that as well.
And there was a firm no.
Yeah, there was absolutely not.
Yes.
No. Well, I'm glad it went that way. I mean, she's so sick to ride with, and she's competitive, which I really like. I think it kind of fired me up to be like, all right, fine, like, let's do this tiebreaker. And she pulled through and won, and it was such a fun day. I'm really stoked. That was the first time I'd ever done slalom, and I don't know, just really sick.
I think your guys' matchup was the most exciting of the day, personally. I mean,
absolutely.
The first race, it's like you were ahead, she was ahead, and then back, and then the ending, it was amazing.
Yeah, totally. I kind of knew it was going to be like a real tiebreaker when I could hear everyone at the bottom kind of cheering. And I was like, oh, got to kind of get serious about this, I guess.
Well, and you did make Lucas Magoon proud with the layback. Maybe Mike Rav, a couple others. There's a lot of proud people to see that.
That was almost a shiver.
Snow. Yeah, it was a shiver.
Was
I would say that was a rendition of a shiver.
Yeah, say it was a shiver for sure.
Proud.
So moving into today. Okay, so now you've got you've done your slalom event. Now you show up here, and you've got this crazy wall ride quarterpipe thing plus a hip. How do you feel on hips? What's your opinion of hips? Are you comfortable out there on hips?
I mean, I love a good slushy hip, especially when it's sunny, and especially when you're riding with all your homies. It's so fun. I don't ever get the opportunity though to ride a hip to this magnitude. I mean, kind of going up the chair and staring at it for the last couple of days has been pretty nerve-wracking. It's really tall, and it's got a bunch of kick, too, so you really get put up in the air, and that just makes me want to give kudos out to Takeru and Mark and Raibu for going absolutely ham on that thing. They were sending it and almost going to the very end of the hip, which I thought was really sick.
Yeah, one thing I gotta give you huge props for is I think that with your tweak, maybe not the amplitude is Raibu and Talker, because those guys were basically getting shot out of a cannon, but you had the dopest tweak out of any of the methods I've seen today.
We were unanimous in that.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. That one felt really good, so I appreciate that.
It was good. Good lockout the whole nine yards.
Somebody was mentioning you had the hood up. You were kind of throwing some Scott Blum vibes out on the way.
Yeah, you were kind of low-key. Yeah, very photogenic, all black.
Yes.
A photographer's
especially
dream.
Especially with that light out there. And all black, like, what a combination.
We call that the woods blender.
Yes. It was sunny. I was kind of happy to drop the jacket and get into some lighter layers, which was pretty nice. Even though it got kind of cloudy, it was still really warm. And yeah, I mean, kind of cut from the same cloth. I'm honored to be seen as maybe a replica of Scott Blum. That's awesome.
Then speaking of Blum, you threw down a good plant. You got up there. You got second in the wall, or third? Second or third?
I think I got second. Yeah. Second in the wall plant. Jamie got up there.
You guys looked close. I think that was up for debate, I thought.
Yeah, I think so. Hmm. We have to look back at the photos. Well,
I'm sure that there's been a judged call on that.
Yeah,
is there a hand plant gate happening? Is there plant gate?
No, not plant gate.
There's no plant gate. No.
Okay. Luckily, it's not
numbers,
up to us.
Yeah. With the numbers,
apparently we weren't paying attention enough.
I mean, you look at the photos, you look at the numbers, it's easy to decipher.
Okay.
That's a game of numbers, Grenny.
Yeah.
It's really a game of numbers.
It is. I mean, we could break out a calculator and really break it down, but we're not good.
Yeah, we don't want to bore the viewers, but what we do want to do is cut to a montage. So we've been basically playing montages of all the riders as the progression of the session happened.
Booyah.
So here we got Reggie
coming in hot.
Dude.
Wow.
That is.
I love how that angle makes it look like he goes to the top.
That's
you know?
He was probably.
A little bit of a sneaky Pete angle.
Let's get a close number on this one. Where are we at?
Where's that hand? Wow.
That's 20.
19, 20?
Yeah, I was going 20 on that.
So that you could flip a coin with Max on that. Those are both. Those
he
are
probably
both
looked
up there.
As far as like comfortability goes, I think Red probably looked the most comfortable flying up the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, from the start. I mean, he started doing those and everyone was cheering. And I think it got everyone into the mode to want to get on that thing. It's really nerve-wracking being at the top and seeing the numbers. I think that's the gnarliest part because you don't want to go only 5 feet. Or anything, and it's just crazy to see the boys chucking, going high, and Jamie getting up there too. Like, it was really sick.
How's that wall slide when you're hitting it?
I wonder
if we lubed it up for Zeb if he would have like shot even higher out of that thing. You know,
just waxed it.
Yeah. I was thinking like hot oil or something. I don't know, just something to really shoot him.
Just rub.
Some baking grease?
Yeah, just rub Brock's jacket on it.
Yes, that would have actually worked the best.
Get some motor oil on there. That'd be perfect.
Just something to really shoot him out.
Speaking of getting shot out, look at
McMorris.
That's a true professional.
And if you landed near the top of that thing, there was virtually no impact at all.
I mean, look at this.
Zero impact. But if you landed a couple feet below, you're pretty bummed.
Yeah. You thudded pretty good.
Yeah.
There's Hales.
Yep.
Oh, there's that method we're talking about. Yeah,
perfect.
Bud, did you get a photo of that?
Look at the ride away.
I was shooting Zeb on the other side during that time.
Yeah, this harsh. Madness.
Yeah, that guy's a maniac. What do you think about Zeb's riding today?
Oh, my gosh. If he was in this, I mean, dead giveaway, he would take it for sure. Highest hand plant.
What are the odds of you getting on Zeb's board and taking some runs?
that would be tight.
Virtually zero. I would say goodbye to my ACLs real fast.
Oh, and right there, the Craig's double chuck there.
Yeah, can we rewind that, or is that we don't have the capabilities?
Rewinding. Next year, we'll get that.
Do not have the capabilities.
We don't. Just want a reminder that we don't know what we're doing. So
there probably is a way.
Just barking orders.
That's right. This is all being run through a toaster.
Yes. The files are in the computer, I've been told.
That's right.
Yeah.
The Japanese guys up there had to get a drone permit, I was told, that they went so high today. It was basically
a helicopter license. Yeah, airspace.
Airspace.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, clearance.
But NASA had to
traffic
be brought in.
Control?
Yeah. Right. Air traffic control.
Foreign object in the sky.
Yeah, well, the UAPs, I think they call
UFOs.
Them.
UFOs. UFOs going on.
So we just had Max on here a couple minutes ago, and you guys all went up this morning and got to rip down a bunch of POW straight into the half park. So did you get a chance to actually ride the half park at all?
No. Our train line was the first time I had been through it, so that was pretty awesome.
What's first impressions for half park for you?
First impressions, I mean, there was a lot of chaos going on with like 50 other riders in front of me, but it seems so sick and fluid. It reminds me so much of a skate park. It's really chill. The first two jumps are a little bit smaller, but they put you up higher so you can kind of focus more on those stylish tricks, which I think is really cool and important. And that battleship rail is real tall, but I think my focus tomorrow is going to be more on the quarter pipe. Mm-hmm. Never really get to do quarter pipes during my season, so pretty sick to see this one cut out in the middle, little channel, and it'll be fun to get on.
Let's talk about that. So you've had a crazy season, right? You've done the Olympics and all the qualifier and that nutty business that all comes with getting to the Olympics and having a chance to compete on that biggest, you know, stage of sport. Contrast that with coming here and doing the Peace Park Championships. What's the contrast for you there?
I feel like everything's a lot safer and you're a little bit more motivated to be progressive because it's fun and you're with your friends and it's not any real sort of competition and kind of feels more like just shredding the mountain with your homies, which I think brings the best snowboarding out of everyone.
Now, would the FIS ever postpone an event until noon because there was some POW? does that happen? Would the FIS do that?
They should take some notes.
Yeah.
It would be epic. Yeah. But.
Now I gotta talk. We should talk strategy because you're number two in points. Let's go ESPN.
Oh, here we go. Sports analytics
here.
Yeah, here we go.
I want to pick your brain here because you got Elena. She's been riding backcountry all year. You've been riding park. You might have a leg up on that department. And then I just want to talk strategy because tomorrow, obviously Jamie, Zoe, they're going to be ripping. Every one of the ladies is going to be ripping. Now, are you going to take it easy tonight, or are you going to drink like 75 beers and wake up in a snowbank? What do you think? What's your technique to get ready for tomorrow?
Definitely be in the snow bank.
Yes. That is the correct answer.
Okay. Bring it back to the roots.
If we see you, we'll put a blanket on you and leave you.
Perfect.
It was better when you hated us.
Respect that technique.
Who are you thinking is going to be going off tomorrow, in your opinion?
I think Zoe and Tess and Annika are really going to go absolutely insane, but can't really forget about the half pipe that's in the middle. And that's kind of, I don't leave Elena or Q or Jamie out. I mean, I'm kind of hoping Elena wants to bust out that double rodeo again. Ooh. That would be pretty sick. But yeah, I mean, really tomorrow, I don't think anyone has an advantage. I think it's kind of anyone's game. Yeah.
Love it. Love cool. to see it. Well, you know what? I think, Kyle, it could be a good time to cut to another quick break.
You can be well-dressed. You can be well-mannered.
Oh, no, no. After you.
You can be well-groomed. Or even well-spoken. But there's just something about being well-adventured. Adventure has a new look. Discover more in the all-new Subaru Forester Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru.
So many flavors of dew. I am thirsty. I must get a dew.
Cut! Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the dew.
Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
I'm on my way home. I'm on my way back to stay. I can't do without you another night. Oh, baby, I'm on my way home.
The 2022 Woodward Peace Park Championships.
America's first carbon.
Can you memorize these words for us?
Hello.
Words come out of our mouths.
We're back.
Welcome back.
We are. Oh, hold on. Are you set up?
We have a new guest. Yeah, we set him
test,
up.
Test, test, test.
Hi. I got him set up.
We're back here. We have yet another guest. Thank you to Haley Langland for coming in. We have Big Air Jer has joined us in the studio.
What's up, Todd?
How are you, sir?
I'm doing good.
You sound good.
I'm feeling good.
Yeah, okay, great.
You like you are feeling good.
Were you enjoying the local Ronde Van festivities?
Yep, been catching up on the bluegrass over at the Ronde Van Festival.
Who's playing Fish?
Is it just me, or does all the bluegrass kind of sound the same? I have a really
hard
time.
Banjo.
Like,
I know
it's
a lot of banjo.
On.
I think one song started at 3 o'clock, and now it's almost 6:30.
I thought it was the one song loop, and there's
it was
different people playing.
I think it was a 3-hour guitar solo I heard earlier. A lot of banjo in the background. What's the patchouli oil level over there?
I think it's less patchouli and more like trust fund sprinter van.
Oh, yeah. Got it. Yeah. Okay.
Gotcha. A lot of slackline.
Yeah, a lot
half
of slack
a million
line.
In a sprinter going on out there. There's 500 sprinter vans.
Yeah.
I heard James Jackson is selling his sprinter van for $116,000 if anyone's interested.
Sweet. Oh, wow. Sweet. Sidebar,
leave a message in the comments if anyone wants to make a sale. Maybe Bombhole will get a commission.
Yeah, we'll do a link in bio
if
on
you got
Bombhole
any
for that.
Money lying around and interested in a van life or a Ronde van up here at Mount Bachelor.
Well, Big Air, this kid's had a big year. You know, before we talk about you kind of just absolutely demolishing the competition here at Peace Park, let's talk about Natty Selection.
Yeah.
What do you want to know?
The kid shined.
Kid in AK, T. Ricky.
Did you get in Rice's mind or did he get in yours?
Yeah.
Dude, so he got in mine. So
I want to hear this story.
So I was like the first, because they get a plane, you know, take a plane out to this glacier. Mm-hmm. And I was on the first load with like Elena and Marion. And get out there, like Travis is supposed to be there, like whatever, doing his thing. And it's like, get out there. I'm like, yo, where's Travis? He's like, oh, he's out riding right now. Like, oh, Travis is out riding right? Like, he's practicing right now? Like, the best Alaskan snowboarder of all fucking time is.
That's the word we were talking about, but let's go.
Keep going.
But yeah, so then, like, gets back, flies in a helicopter, swoops in, then just, like, comes in and throws his sleeping bag in my tent. He's like, what up, roomie? I'm like, oh, really? Like, that's pretty funny. And then, yeah, I didn't know I was going against him until later. But, yeah, he was, like, just, like, I woke up one morning, he's just staring at me, just.
Staring at you. He probably set his alarm on it just to
yeah,
freak you
and
out.
I was, like, trying to, like, pick his brain on some advice about some Alaskan lions and, like.
Can you trust him at that point, though, when you're.
I can't. Well, he also doesn't. He can't translate it to, like, my level. He's, like, yeah. Just, that looks pretty good. And you're like, what do you mean? Like, what do you, like.
A little bit of a question mark at the end of the sentence, dude.
Yeah, he's like, yeah, that looks pretty good. I'm like, all right, perfect. Thanks, Travis. Let's, I guess, drop.
The kid held his own. Yes. The kid, and then, I mean, talking about over when you were in Jackson. Holy yes. smokes, that was a freaking show, dude. Wow.
Yeah, that was a ride for sure. And I was like, from the start, like, I got, like, the call from Liam like 2 weeks before, and he's like, yeah, you want to do it? I'm like, of course, like, let's sick. And then so I was just like hyped to be there, and then I'm like, all right, all I want to do is like make it past the next round so I can go to Baldface. And then just like found out that like the people from Baldface are going to Alaska. I'm like, oh, sick, like, this is perfect. And then just like kept on advancing, and then yeah, I got to the final round with Sage and had a good run and just good showing, and it was a lot of fun. So
kid's gonna have new contracts in the mail.
You didn't know a couple new connies.
Was there, they were kind of short on people, and they just waited till the very, very end? And I think someone backed out. They finally called Big Air Jer.
I guess so. I don't know.
And then you cleaned up out there. So mm-hmm.
Yeah, I made the selection committee look good, I guess. So shout out to them. I don't know.
In Salt Lake, we were cheering for you. I'll tell you that.
Little did
I heard you
know
guys were cheering
was...
for Sage.
No, I was cheering for you.
I had all my money on Sage.
Yeah, I was cheering for you.
Yeah,
I was.
Yeah, I know you were going. I haven't watched your broadcast, but yeah. I heard you were going all in on Sage.
I was all in on Big Air Jer.
I made some money on that.
Natty Select was actually the qualifier series. Yeah, it was a qualifier series for the Peace Park Championships.
It was. You're absolutely right. Yeah. Yeah,
I don't see how else I would get in.
Yes. Exactly.
So let's talk about your, you did great racing yesterday, too.
Yes.
You know, you're just smashing gates.
You were angry as a racer should be.
Was it true about the water bottles in the jacket?
Yeah.
Yes, had a water bottle in the jacket. The Norwegian was kind of doing some ski racer tricks. And I didn't want a bruised arm at the end of the day, and the only way to beat
those
that
aren't
tech
ski
is to
racer
use that
tricks.
Tech.
Those are actually actual racing techniques to do a better job in the course.
At one point, you had a gate.
They are not funny tricks.
You had a gate in your hand to potentially spear the person next to you.
Did I?
Yeah, it was like Hunger Games out there.
You caught a gate in your hand, and you were like had it raised above your head at one point in the race.
I guess I blacked out racing.
Who are your victims? Who are your victims? Because you kind of were picking them off. You went all the way to the finals.
Yeah. Took out DeBuck, and hometown hero Mason Lemery.
Wow, that was you went middle finger at the end. I saw on that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yes. I kind of went. Well, he was talking his smack.
That was one of my favorite moments of the day.
What was he chirping?
You're going down, dude. But he was like trying to like talk smack. But it was
we should pull up the highlight again. Throw that on the screen while we talk about
Sebbe
this.
Sebbe is too tall to go.
He's
as
too
fast.
Tall. Yeah. He was doing from the start.
Talk about drag.
But
if
he used Mons tech, he would have been fine. Because Mons is a big guy too. And then McMomo kind of took out himself. I can't really take credit for that.
True. He kind of slipped on a banana peel out
there. Yeah, and then Roisland in the final.
We got some highlights on
Racing's racing, you know. A win's a win.
A win is a win.
It's not really up for debate. You just simply won.
It's not a style game out there.
Yeah, it's not subjective.
It's not judged. It's time.
That's right.
It's simply I'm better than you and I'm faster than you in all ways.
If exactly. You're first, you're last.
That's why we love it.
You are an inferior human to me at this point in time. Exactly. And we can't even argue it.
I think we're going to see the next race here. We're going to see Mark Moe go full snowplow with his face. That's true. Yes, it is. Here it is.
See, he had me in the start, you know?
Oh, this is the one. Yeah, this is where Big Air was. He was spiteboarding at this point. He's like, I don't have it. And then he gave it away.
Yep, sorry.
So
Mark.
Really,
he probably could have won that one.
Yeah, he probably could have won that.
He would have had you.
He would have had you.
Yep.
And then this is you and Mason. You're on the right there.
Yep.
Look at him get low.
Oh, another one down.
There it is.
There's
there
the middle finger.
Is.
Yeah. There's what we're talking about.
Well, I was saying earlier, he was trying to talk smack to me, but it was kind of one of those situations where he just kept on doing it, and then I wouldn't say anything back, and he kind of got in his own head.
See, that's
a good technique.
Yeah, it's a good tech. Doesn't always work, though. Didn't work with Travis.
You should try that on Rice, and the next time you're with him, just have him wake up with you just staring at him.
Yes.
Doesn't matter what you guys are doing. Just stare at Rice always.
Dude,
do it at like 4 a.m., too. Like, really freak him out with a lantern by your face or something like like, Travis, you're sleeping.
Travis, wake up.
I was calling him Pop Up there.
You're calling him Pop Up?
Pop Up.
Pop Up. Like, he's much older than him. That's a good technique to get in his head.
Are you feeling old? You're pretty old. Are you feeling okay? Because I'm young and spry.
Yeah.
My knees are great. How about your knees that are 20 years older than my knees?
Pop, pop.
Seems like they work pretty good on that 80-foot back three.
His knees have no problem.
Yeah, Pop Pop's doing great.
Legend has it. He has cyborg legs on there, and that's how he's able to do that.
Legend also has it. I think we got another montage we can cut to. Kyle, what's going on that thing? We got anything left in there?
Hey, Chris, I saw you with a radar gun today.
I did. It was hard to gauge. Oh, this is my iPhone edit.
Wow.
Right here.
Oh, wow. Here you go. This is shaky cam. I drank too much coffee
earthquake.
Out there.
This is earthquake cam.
Yeah, was there a minor tremor?
Yes.
Is this Tremor 6?
Yeah, starring Kevin Bacon, actually. Kevin Bacon. Yeah, he's the main character.
Tremor 6.
It's the Tremors Attack Pack is what they call it. The 6-disc volume DVD
set. We're
going
to need to get you a gimbal, bud.
And speaking of 6-disc DVD, Raibu going to the moon.
The Mason Back Rodeo was twisted.
Kid was twisted off the potion is what I hear.
Yeah, twisted. Yep. How fast did you clock these guys in? Any tickets being written?
We had about, I think Raibu clocked at 40-something miles an hour when he did.
He had a radar gun.
The booster.
For real.
Yeah.
I think Zeb clocked in at about 175 miles an hour.
Thing we did notice, Jer, is we were clocking you at about 38 miles an hour, and then you would throw a cinder block out the back of the car and slow way down. Like, you were coming in
anchors
hot, like
away.
You wanted to eat the wall ride, and you would do 7 speed checks.
It's scary going into that thing. Mason, I mean, whatever. That thing just got so choppy at the end, I'm just like, Do I really need to go to the top of this thing? Like,
you kept going though. That's what we really admired. Is like, we were like, well, I think everyone's done, and then you'd come flying down again.
It was like whatever.
Drop the anchor
from the start of the day. I was like, I'll try and get to the top of that thing, and then just like kept on dropping higher, and then I would just like speed check and go slower. Then if I dropped at the slower point, I'm like,
how high did you get up there today?
Not high enough.
I think 14
or 15 feet high.
Yeah. Let's talk about your boy Mason real quick. We were going to maybe try to get him in the booth. I don't know where he's at, but he's
snow skating on the mountain right now with Brock Crouch.
Of course he is.
He's trying some gaps.
This guy is exciting.
He's my favorite snowboarder to watch.
Yeah, not afraid to send.
No, not afraid of anything.
I heard
he's
an explosive device a lot of times.
You don't know what's going to happen.
How old is this kid? You never know what's going to happen. He's either 21 or 22. He may either just turn 22 or he's 21, I think.
He's looking good
out there. He's got one mode, like, completely wide open, and he's either going to land something spectacular or he's going to explode.
It's AKA
he's going
beast
to,
mode
yeah,
out
like,
there.
That's exactly. He's going to do a miracle trick that doesn't make any sense, or he's going to. Dude, we went up after we were hitting the cornice today, which is like this classic Mount Bachelor cliff, and we're like filming it, and then he like tries a cab five, kind of like messes up, and then just like goes up, drops like 30 feet higher, and just does like an 80-foot backflip just to like the bottom and
that.
Just like exploded.
It's called showmanship.
That was amazing.
Dude, just like complete, like lost all his stuff, and then there's this other like tabletop, like perfect tabletop, like on the run down, and then just like busts a perfect backside rodeo 7, just like stomps the piss out of it, and you're like, you never know what to expect from the kid.
Yeah, it's roulette, man. It's a game of roulette
out there. He's coming in super hot on the scene. We love to see it.
Yeah exactly.
And you call him Mason Jara.
Yeah, I mean, that's just his Instagram name. It's like you just get caught.
Did you pick your own Instagram?
You get caught in
the
handle.
Or were you given the Big Air Jer?
Yeah.
It was kind of given. It was like, so we were hitting this like jump at Bachelor when we were like super, or like 14 or whatever. And like, Big Air Jer, because like, they call me Jer, and they're like, Big Air Jer. I'm like, fuck. Instagram name. Perfect. Mm-hmm. Like,
yep.
And then just, yeah, it's stuck since, I guess.
Solid fit. Solid
the handle
fit.
The handle sticks, right?
The handle sticks. I've thought about changing it because it is kind of cringe. But
let me tell you something. If
I don't
the
think
shoe
it's
fits, wear it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I don't think it's cringe. It's kind of just you right now and you're living up to the name.
You should just change it to Travis Rice 2.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
If you get older, you start falling off. You can be small air.
How about
Gare,
younger
small
than Travis
Gare.
Rice?
Yeah, I'm going to change it once I get older and stop hitting stuff.
But now you can keep landing in the parking lot and we'll be
there.
Yeah. Take it to the parking lot for now.
Well, should we take a quick commercial break?
Yeah.
What do you guys think about
Sounds
that over
great.
In the media room?
Let's pay.
You guys heard about Mountain Dew?
Yeah, let's pay the bills.
Pretty good.
There you go.
You can be well-dressed. You can be well-mannered.
Oh, no. After you.
You can be well-groomed. Or even well-spoken. But there's just something about being well-adventured. Adventure has a new look.
Discover more in the all-new Subaru Forester Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru.
So many flavors of Dew. I am thirsty. I must get a Dew.
Cut! Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the Dew.
Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
I'm on my way home. I'm on my way back to stay. I can't do without you and another night. Oh, baby, I'm on my way home.
The 2022 Woodward Peace Park Championships are being brought to you by Fat Tire, America's first certified carbon neutral beer. By Mountain Dew, proud partner of Peace Park. And by the all-new Subaru Forester Wilderness.
We're back.
Hey,
we're back in the booth here at the Bombhole Peace Park.
The Booch.
Whatever we're calling this thing. Junk Show, which is really what we should call
it. It's a solid junk show.
We got Big Air Jer, if you're just tuning in. He's doing great in this event. He got second in the race. He was doing some high plants. He just destroyed natural selection. But I believe I just got word from our producers here. We got some more footage to talk about. So let's throw this on the screen, and maybe, Big Air, you can talk us through this.
So here we got Max Warbington. I mean, kind of a weird shot for the montage, but seems like he pulled out of that one just fine.
Not really an A grade, but we'll go with it.
I liked it. I like the back three.
We're going two angles on it. Yeah. So,
let's show it again.
This is called the mime plant. It's just miming his way around.
The rainbow plant, right?
They just shuffled the hard drive.
Oh, three. We're going four.
Oh, we're going four.
Yep. Can we get a five?
Is anyone have an iPhone or a drone angle?
Is there a drone?
Oh, look at that, Japan.
Yeah, that was Japan air.
Cut out the last guy.
Dan got cut out on that one. Oh, that was my favorite. No grab alley oop.
Red kind of talked me out of the hip today until like the last 10 minutes when they said
psychological warfare. There's Jamie with that Andrek.
Yeah, I want to say Haley might have went higher. I don't know. That was my.
Let's see where that hand goes.
That's at seven.
Seven, but was that the one?
Yeah, that's true.
That's a good point.
That might. I think she did one bigger or two. After. I think. This was nice. This
is dude, kind of he did that off the cornice today. He was with us. He hit a front seven.
I didn't know he landed that. I thought he went down.
Yeah, I kind of thought he put his high back in his butt.
This kid's vibe
that was
nice
actually
out
presented
there
by
too.
Depends Diapers because I saw a couple people that had soiled their pants
dude,
on that.
Dude, that also happened on the wall. A couple.
Yeah, there's a couple Depends moments on the wall. Yeah,
tears.
Yep. A couple tears in the undergarments from what I hear.
Here we go.
I would like to see Haley Langland riding that just to see what it looks like for proportions.
It's twice her size. Dude.
Wow.
Dude, there's a photo there that's probably a screen grab I'd like to see. Just full pencil. The pencil.
Whoa.
Oh, wow. That was the one where he almost got his hand up on the top.
Dude, so many times today, just from the chairlift, Zeb was just chilling up there like, Zeb, you're the man! Like, everyone up there just like, I'm like, dude, this guy's a straight
He's
celebrity.
The people's
it's
champ.
Insane.
Mm-hmm. Here's another Jamie. This might be. Where's she at?
Eight?
Put her at eight. Okay, yeah. Mark her down for eight.
Put her at eight.
Let's call that a clean eight.
Yep.
There's another shot of it right there. Wow.
Yep, second angle.
What do we got?
Is that Tess?
Tess. Yep.
Nice front side invert. She's getting those. She said this is the first time she's ever really done those. She usually does Miller flips. Oh, wait. There it is.
There's the method.
There it is.
That's what the people like to see.
That was nice.
The Warbington rewind.
Another angle. All right.
Sorry about that.
Pretty dope.
That was sick.
That's a trick right there.
Yeah, that was some salsa picante pepper. Oh, there's the grenade.
Yep. That's mason jar.
That's young liability. Your boy's a problem.
Throwing
right
a mason jar at the wall.
Wow. That's that OG Jake Price behind the knee grab is what we call that.
Wow, that was a scary event right there. Maybe, I don't know if you saw the size of where – Mace made that giant bomb
I felt
hole.
It.
Yes.
I felt it.
You felt it on one of your landings.
Yep.
Yeah, that looks like Timmy running hot tub is what we call that. He's known for landing on his back in the backcountry, our good friend.
Yeah, now, whirlpool.
One thing about Mason I noticed is it doesn't take much to get him to try something. I think he was over it, and we said, Mason, you should go back up and front flip that wall, and it doesn't take much to get him.
It doesn't take a lot.
Just give him a little poke, and
it does not take a lot. I mean, last night we were watching this, and we're like, Mason, odds you go in and just shotgun a beer on set. 1 in 10 Just not hard to convince to do anything. He's like, should we do this?
Doesn't handle peer pressure well.
Yes. No, he does.
Very susceptible to peer pressure.
Yeah, peer pressure, if you don't handle it well.
Hard to talk him out of something, too, if he's...
Once he's in?
Like, yeah, I think I'm going to switch method this. You're like, you sure? Yeah, I got it. Like, all right, I'm filming. Like, and then all of a sudden, you got 200,000 views on your Instagram post. It's great.
Yeah, wow,
that's incredible.
Are we gonna go one more montage?
Yeah, we got another montage.
Because the final
Right? Let's have Big Air talk us through this final sesh. He's a great comment.
Here we go.
This is session 3, correct?
Is there a couple more shots of Max's backside?
Yeah, do we have any on the wall?
Can we open with that?
Nope,
maybe?
No, yeah. We're getting.
Can we find the drone angle?
Yeah, maybe we could do 6 or 7 more shots of that.
Yeah, we didn't see the drone.
No drones.
We had a drone in this booth.
Yeah, we could. They did fly away.
Those guys, they threw one in the building.
If you notice the intro shot, I think we talked about it briefly, but just if you notice E-Stone with the leg up looking like Christian Slater.
It's more of a Matthew McConaughey vibe from that one movie.
Yeah, I was going to say McConaughey for sure.
I get older, they stay the same age.
You know, I don't know if you've noticed it. When you go to the summit, up to the summit chair, there's a little garden gnome that looks an awful lot like E-Stone off to the side in the snow.
You
know,
I got something going with Target promo. Model Target garden gnome coming out.
How tall is the resi on that one?
Oh, it's sky high.
You guys, if I can get small
four-fist
small ball sacks made of plastic, you guys can easily have garden gnomes made of E-Stone.
Yeah, we gotta look into that. Yeah. We got people looking into
There's
that.
There's a lot of merchandising opportunities.
We're going to be working on a full mold of it. It's going to be great.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, let's talk about our sponsors for a quick second here.
Thirsty, bold, refreshing. So good.
Oh, it looks like we're in a screensaver.
We need to go higher.
Higher.
Definitely higher.
We're like yodeling high.
Yodeling?
No, don't do that.
We should go even higher.
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh, I'm good.
Me too.
Adventure has a new look.
Let's go lower.
Lower.
That sounds good.
Discover more in the all-new Subaru Outback Wilderness. Love. It's what makes Subaru, Subaru.
All right, hey, we're back.
We are back.
Yeah,
welcome to 101.5, the bomb hole. Chris Grenier here. Stony Buds, how you doing?
I'm doing great, my dog. Hey, we're joined here. Why don't you just introduce yourself? What's going on here? Who do we have in the booth?
Okay.
Come on, fly this plane.
I'm Dan. Dan Davis here. You're tuned into the later version of the bomb hole podcast here at Peace Park. We got Sean Malto and my good friend Cookie, some friends of mine, skaters from my fellow sponsor Mountain Dew, good snowboarders actually too. These guys rip.
Solid.
We were definitely somersaulting around some powder today. I don't know if we were that great.
Did you find some soft snow?
Yeah, we found some fresh stuff out there. It was we were working hard though.
Yeah.
I mean, you get stuck in those trees. It's tough to get
back leg on fire.
You know what? I'm like, ever since I had ankle surgery, I'm always on my front leg, which is probably a reason why I'm getting stuck out there.
No.
I need some pro tips, you know?
I always hear people complain about their back leg
and really?
Powder. Yeah, when you're sitting, kind of back leg powder, trying to.
Can we talk about these pants you got on right now? What is happening? You got sleeping bag pants on.
Todd, I don't know if you've been outside, but we're camping. Right. I know you're down in Bend.
Camping
in the,
is a lifestyle, apparently.
Seasons,
24 hours a day camping.
We hang out outside, and the what you. Where are you at? Where are you staying?
They got me at the Sheraton.
Yeah, exactly.
This guy's in the spa. You're walking around outside.
You know, we got bomb hole budget to throw around here.
I thought I'd throw on the puffy kit. You got the puffy boots.
You're fitting right in up here.
Yeah. No, I try to.
Yeah, so you, matching head to toe.
Yeah. I try to. You know, when we're camping, you need the warm gear. It gets cold out there, especially when the sun goes down. You walk outside right now. Not 60 degrees anymore. It was a nice day out there, though.
So you got Mountain Dew sponsors all you guys. They've, you know, given you this opportunity at Peace Park to kind of bring all your friends here together for this. What's, you know, what's the vibe so far for you? It's one thing to like kind of draw this out on a napkin, and then another thing to see it actually come to fruition. What are your thoughts so far on what's happening here?
It's great, you know, and friends like these coming to show up at this thing where not only friends of like being action sports related friends.
Malto's at all the like, all the Dew tours. He's all, at all the snowboard events these days.
I love it. I think it's amazing.
He's a good boarder, you know. He's a good boarder, and Cookie as well. I met Cookie in Vermont quite some time ago. I would imagine.
Are you from Vermont?
I am. Yes.
Where in Vermont?
Just outside of Burlington, like half Williston, half Colchester.
Cool, cool. Yeah. Right on.
Cookie's got all the street spots in Burlington. If anybody's looking to go to Champlain or...
The place is very fond to me.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Clocked a lot of hours at UVM in Champlain, but never went there.
Exactly.
I spent more time on this campus than any of you students.
Yeah, right?
Fully. And they're pretty friendly about you skating it, yeah?
They are. Yeah. They really are.
I haven't done any snowboarding there. I'm not much of a street snowboarder, but...
I had some friends growing up who would get down street snowboarding around town, and they'd light stuff up at UVM and
there's spots
around town. There are.
Zeb's like, got some spots.
Yeah, my one friend would like grind a rail off a parking structure that was like two or three stories drop.
Yep.
And it's just like uncomprehendable to me.
The hospital hip is a famous one.
Mm. It is, yeah, where they ride the wall, I think.
It's like the parking garage is here, and then they pile up all the snow from there. It dumps over, and then there's a big pile of snow.
It's legendary.
It's a very I've hit it before with Billy Anderson, actually.
There you go. Let's switch gears from Vermont back to why the hell people are spending a lot of money to give you an event here.
This has been a fantastic event. I get to invite people like Sean and Cookie. I get to invite all my friends from snowboarding. My dad's here. You know, there's music that we're kind of, you know, we're not a part of Rendezvous. We're kind of our own thing in Peace Park, but we got music going on. Mm-hmm. It's a very like, I don't know, something I kind of like to do.
Yeah.
Snowboard and hang out and camp in the lot. And to just be able to not only build this course that's really fun to ride and invite all these people here to enjoy it, I get to bring people like these guys and like my pops and we all get to have just a rad weekend. And it's not about competing or who wins, or it's kind of just more of a fun weekend with your friends.
Well, let's talk about today's festivities up on the hill. So we had, you know, we've been talking about the quarter pipe hand plant and the hip air. We're going to show a montage. We have this other montage. Okay, we got another montage here. Dan, so just kind of talk us through what went down today and what we're in store for tomorrow, because tomorrow is kind of like the big capper for this event, isn't it?
It is. Tomorrow's kind of the last day. We got a big, like, kind of public ride day on Sunday, and that's kind of the cherry on top is, like, the public gets to rip that. But tomorrow, Saturday, is going to be sort of, we're calling it Half Park, but it's really the Peace Park. Like, we did a wall ride and a highest air today, and Zeb went psycho. Raibu went psycho. Max Warbington really showed up. Reggie showed up. I mean, look at this clip, dude. It's so insane. It was a really good session, and I had my questions when I showed up. The wall looked really big, really skinny, and it worked. Like, look at that. Like, Zeb's on a 190. I don't know if that's harder or working to his advantage. I'm not really sure. But this was a great session, and I think tomorrow we can expect another fun one. The jumps aren't huge. We're not going to be like conquering the world with our airtime tomorrow, but it's a rad fun course that there's a ton of different lines in. I think we're going to see some of the slope style boys shine. I think some of the half pipe crew is going to bust out some of their expertise in certain parts of the zone. So we have half park tomorrow starting in the midday, and we'll be at you guys in the evening with an edit and some winners.
Haley was saying that she really likes that course because it's really flowy. And I think that's what like any of the peace parks at any of the resorts across the U.S. represents. It's like, you know, you want that cement skate park flow where it's not just – you're not just hitting a jump, or you're
kind of working with the terrain over
right
there. Bachelor is kind of a unique mountain where you've got a lot of like just rolly. It's not about the steep cliffs and chutes and things here. It's about like all these wind lips and knolls and things you can pop over. So there's these really great land features that really kind of directed what we were going to do with our Peace Park. You know, sure, it's like there's a jump on this left side because the hill comes up over there, and it's sort of like street skating in a way, but with terrain, with like 1,000 vertical feet of terrain.
Like, sounds exactly like street skating.
Yeah, it's like some San Francisco.
Hundreds
yeah
of thousands of dollars of equipment moving snow around, but it's a lot like the streets.
Yeah, no, it kind of, you know, you're working with the terrain though. You got to have speed where you need it and shut it down where you don't. And so it's a beautiful, it's a perfect run for what we're trying to do tomorrow. It's going to be fun.
And like I said, Sean, you've been at a lot of the Dew Tour events. I always see you at like the Copper Mountain event over the years, and you're no stranger to getting out and throwing yourself around in the snow. What's it like to come here and watch something like, I mean, obviously there's Mega Ramp and skateboarding, and Danny Way is from a different planet, him and Bob and Elliot yeah and all those dudes. But you watch something like this where like, it doesn't really seem like it's possible at first. You know, what do you think when you see a 24-foot high wall ride, like on top of a 24-foot high quarter pipe?
I mean, it makes zero sense to me. I like look at it and I'm automatically scared. I thought Zeb was going to die like 100 times today. I seriously was. It looked so wrong so many times, and he somehow just lands it every time.
Dude, he goes
time
in. He must go into this like mental state that's just like, I got this. Just chill.
And dude, like, how does he get out of that?
Late rock and roll to like with shuffled. One, like down.
With a 190 or a 200 centimeter snowboard, the thing is huge.
It is so sick though. I have so much respect.
Yeah, he's a sender in all scenarios. Yeah, like any time on the mountain with that kid is a blast. But it was a show out there today.
What are you looking for tomorrow?
I think, well, so the standings, I don't know if you guys have a leaderboard or if you've
we know where it's at.
Leaderboard. Here we go. Yeah. Here's the leaderboard. So I'm seeing like Jared, Sparky, Takeru look like in a really good spot to just go bananas tomorrow. Raibu, I think, will go kind of bananas tomorrow because he's got it in him. Max, really looking forward to watching Max ride. I love his stuff. Dusty, I think, you know, he's sitting in eighth, but don't be fooled. This is like...
It's 40%. The last event is worth 40% of the points.
Tomorrow's kind of for all the cheese, all the beans. Mm-hmm. Or all
marbles.
The marbles. Is
yes,
that what it
marbles
is? Yes, marbles. Sorry.
Cheese, beans.
Cheese, beans, marbles.
I'm starving.
I know. Yeah. It is dinner. If anybody needs food, go eat after this. It's going to be great tomorrow, though. I think we have a nice... I'm not even going to say it, but we have some nice weather tomorrow.
Yeah,
I think it's going to be good.
It's going to be spring break over there on that side of the mountain. So... I mean, are you guys going to be over there tomorrow kind of checking that out?
Yeah, I want to put these guys with you. I want to, like, give them a good view.
Great.
And, like, maybe we get, you know, like, just because it's a hard course to see from one.
Yeah.
It's a long course.
It is a long course, and there's a couple spots that we can kind of look at. As you see right here, here is kind of the fast-forwarding of this morning. This is your power run this morning where you guys kind of came down. Now watch as everyone kind of rolls into this thing. There's a whole bunch of different options. Like these two hips right here, pretty cool.
This is nice. It's poppy and short, and so is this one on your right. It'd be like kind of fun, not crazy amount of airtime or scary. It should be super fun, and I think you'll see a lot of lines. It's not about your best run tomorrow. It's about like the session. How much can you come up with on this thing?
That looks so
sick. Doesn't that look rad? Jeez.
This half pipe wall too is going to be a... either your best friend or your worst friend, because I almost decked on.
So I'm thinking maybe we set up shop on top of that half pipe wall.
I think you want to be on rider's left.
Oh,
that's
yeah?
That's what I was telling these boys. Okay. Yeah, I think you want to be on rider's left, and you'll get a whole view of the course. This is a rail for the first time in Peace Park in a while.
Yeah, how's that? Is Steely Dan going to come out and play tomorrow?
I'm gonna get sideways. All right. I think I usually only 50-50 because then you don't catch your edge.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's get it.
Because I always run sharp edges, and I'm always scared. I'm told it doesn't matter, but I still get scared of going sideways.
I rode past that rainbow rail today. We ducked under the line. We hit the little closed session, but that thing looks gnarly. Yeah, I kind of want to try to 50 that.
No, you got that.
Yeah, you can ride onto it, right?
Yeah.
Or do you got to pop
like,
onto it?
No, there's like a
like 70 miles an hour. It's
yeah,
cool.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah, yeah.
There's like a gap.
But I mean, pretty much little right free up. Air onto it. Yeah. All right.
Your foot isn't even going to be off the snow. Your nose will touch it.
Okay,
first.
Cool.
Just give a little lift.
Yeah, yeah.
You got that. Well,
okay. All right.
We got you.
I want to see that board slide, though.
Yeah. I promise. I'm thinking
Steely
I'm
Dan.
I'm thinking like
that's they call him in the streets.
It's sort of like a spine feature.
Big fan.
So I'm thinking from the side and you know.
Kind of gap out and transfer over.
Yeah, like
is it kinked? Like is there a flat or is it
it's
one rainbow?
Up, flat
and
down.
Down. Okay.
And spines on the side and a jump on the front. So I think I'll come from the side. Back lip would be really rad. Like to the down. I think. I like to think I'm going to, like, do these things, but then Dusty will go do it, like, first run, and he'll just be like, wow.
You got to beat him to it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Or just don't watch.
A Danny Davis back lip is never a bad
thing.
Yeah,
I'm down. I'll make it happen.
It's no contest, right?
It's for y'alls if
there
I do
go.
It.
There you
well,
go.
Sure, it's a contest.
We're going to wrap this up tonight because you guys need to go. Obviously, Dan is starving. He's just talking about beans and cheese over here.
Beans, cheese, and quesadillas.
Yeah, your girl's going to love the bean and cheese meal later on you guys are staying up here in the camper. But so tomorrow we've got the Half Park event is going down. Thanks, you guys, for coming by and hanging
so
out
with us.
So glad
you guys are here.
Yeah,
thanks coming.
Thanks for having us.
And thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
For setting up this whole thing. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is going to be real fun. Tomorrow we're going to be back. We're going to be capping this thing off. We got the leaderboard going. Someone's going to go home with some fabulous prizes tomorrow afternoon.
15 grand. There's no prizes. It's cold, hard cash.
Cold,
Todd.
Hard cash.
15 G's?
15 G's.
Hell yeah.
Someone's
you think
gonna...
my 50 on the rainbow rail, that might cut it, right?
Dude, if you 50 the trap, I got 100.
We'll peel you off.
You got 100?
I got a Venmo.
Wow.
100 bucks.
Wow.
All right.
Take
well,
that straight to Domino's.
We're going
to
hold our breath for that, Malto. We're going to see you just get that 50-50. You're going to have to go in at speed. Maybe you could. You
11
could...
to 3 is the session.
Right.
11 to 3?
Yeah.
No.
All right. One try is all you need, though. One try is all you need. One try for glory.
And Todd's going to give us one beautiful like back seven on one of the kickers.
Okay, so just before we leave, let's talk about me for a second here. I mean, that park is probably one of the more fun-looking parks that I've seen this year that I want to get.
I think you can dabble in there.
Get with, because I don't want to hit a 70-foot kicker anymore. I'm done with that. I'm going to Mexico in like a week. I need stuff that will provide me a landing with the least amount of impact so it won't interfere with my surf vacation.
Just don't overshoot these and you'll be gravy.
All right, well.
The landings are tight. They're steep. But they feel great when you grease them, so we got you.
That being said, all right, we'll see you guys tomorrow night.
Buena noche.
We're going to wrap this thing up. You've been watching the Peace Park.
I must get a do.
Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the do. You can be well-dressed. You can be well-mannered.
Oh, no. After you.
You can be well-groomed. Or even well-spoken. But there's just something about being well-adventured. Adventure has a new look. Discover more in the all-new Subaru Forester Wilderness. Love, it's what makes Subaru, Subaru.
Mountain Dew Spark might hypnotize you. You might want to stop staring. Stop staring at the delicious Mountain Dew Spark.
I'm on my way home. I'm on my way back to stay. I can't do without you another. Oh, baby, I'm on my way home.